Peace TV English, the solution for humanity.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa ahlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli amma ba'd. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you for spending your time trying to learn more about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, trying to understand Allah's beautiful names. And we're continuing with Allah's beautiful names, Al-Khaliq, Al-Bari', Al-Musawwir, and what was the fourth one, remember? Al-Khalaq, mashallah. So Allah Al-Khalaq, the Supreme Creator, Al-Khaliq, the Creator, Al-Bari', the Inventor, and Al-Musawwir, the Fashioner. And we already explained all those in details in the previous episode. There's a very beautiful hadith about the heavens and the earth and the magnitude and their size that I didn't want to overlook and begin the next component afterwards, but I really want to mention this hadith in which Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said, بَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا وَالَّتِي تَلِيهَا. The difference in distance between the sama' al-dunya, the sama' that we see, sama' al-dunya, and the sama' that is right above it, how many years? 500 years. وَبَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ الثَّانِيَا وَالَّتِي تَلِيهَا. And between the second and the third heaven, 500 years. وَبَيْنَ كُلِّ سَمَاءٍ وَسَمَاءٍ. So every sama', the distance between them is 500 years. Subhanallah. Then he says, وَبَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ السَّابِعَةِ وَالْكُرْسِيِ. And this is between the seventh heaven and Allah's Kursi. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he said that Al-Kursi is the footstool of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way that befits Allah's majesty. Do you remember the first episode? Or was it the second one? Nah, the second one. La tahrif, wa la ta'atil, wa la takyif, wa la tamthil. We will not distort, we will not deny, we will not liken, and we will not exemplify and things like that. We'll mention it how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taught his creation about Al-Kursi, about Al-Arsh, etc. So Ibn Abbas says Al-Kursi is the footstool of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ibn Mas'ud says the distance between the seventh heaven and the Kursi is 500 years. And the distance between Al-Kursi to the water is above Al-Kursi, 500 years. And Al-Arsh is right above the water. Wallahu fawqa Al-Arsh. And Allah is above the throne. لا يخفى عليه شيء من أعمالكم. None of your actions is hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah sees everything. Just like how we mentioned about the Surah Al-Mujadila, when Aisha was right next to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and the woman came to complain to the Prophet, and she said, I could not hear the conversation really well, like some words yes, some words not. Then Allah revealed the verse, قَدْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ قَوْلَ الَّتِي تُجَادِلُكَ فِي زَوْجِهَا, until the end of the ayah. Remember that? And she said, Subhanallah, how Allah above seven heavens was able to hear this so clearly. Absolutely. Allah is al-Sami' al-Basir. And He's also al-Khaliq, al-Bari', al-Musawwir, al-Khalaq. Subhanallah. With this being said, brothers and sisters, watch and hear and feel and sense. After all these ahadith, how tiny are we? Aren't we now having that haya and are humble towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That yes, ya Allah, we're here going to fulfill the purpose which You created us for. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pondered upon this hadith. When Allah created the arsh and created these things, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala write in the most sanctified place in the universe? What did Allah write over His throne? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَمَّا قَدَ الْخَلْقِ. When Allah created the creation, كَتَبَ عِنْدَهُ فَوْقَ عَرْشِهِ. Allah wrote on His throne, what did He write? إِنَّ رَحْمَتِي سَبَقَتْ غَضَبِي. My rahma has overpassed, my rahma overcame my anger and wrath. Something, subhanAllah, to make us the sense of comfort. And all of this, we didn't even come to dunya yet. What did Allah create next? The angels. Al-Khalaq, Al-Khalaq, created billions and billions and billions and billions of angels in a huge amount. An authentic hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and don't forget to say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whether you're watching behind the scenes or whatever, he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows 70,000 of the angels to go and circulate around Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur. Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur is like the Kaaba, but not on the dunya. The Kaaba all the way in the seventh heaven, Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur. These 70,000 angels circulate around that Bayt Al-Ma'mur and they never ever come back again. And every time a new set of 70,000 angels come, do tawaf around Al-Bayt Al-Ma'mur and they never come back. Since Allah Al-Khalaq, this is the name, the Supreme Creator. And in Rasulullah ﷺ now, he wants to explain to us the size of some of these angels. Now enjoy this. Rasulullah ﷺ, and I want to ask you a question. How many times did the Prophet see Jibreel in his actual form? How many times? You're close. Actually, you're right. Some of you may be right. Two times. He saw Jibreel in the actual form two times. Rasulullah ﷺ said, لَمْ أَرَهُ عَلَى صُورَتِهِ الَّتِي خُلِقَ عَلَيْهِ غَيْرَ هَاتَيْنِ الْمَرَّتَيْنِ I saw him twice. رَأَيْتُهُ مُنْهَبِطًا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ سَادًّا عِظَمَ خَلْقِهِ مَا بَيْنَ السَّمَاءِ الْأَرْضِ First time I saw him, he covered everything. He covered the horizon. I could not see anything. Rasulullah ﷺ said he came, like that's it. I can't, like, as if I'm doing this. Now I can't see anything. So when Jibreel came, he covered the horizon for how large he was. Subhanallah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Allah has given me the permission to explain to you one of the angels that hold Allah's throne. أُذِنَ لِي أَنْ أُحَدِّثَ عَنْ مَلَكٍ مِّنْ مَلَائِكَةِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى مِنْ حَمَلَةِ الْعَرْشِ Ya Rasulullah, please explain one of these angels that are holding Allah's throne. إِنَّمَا بَيْنَ شَحْمَةِ أُذُنِهِ The distance between the earlobe, this part right here, إِلَىٰ عَاتِقِهِ To the shoulder. You see that distance right here? The distance of the angel's earlobe to the shoulder, the Prophet ﷺ said, مَسِيرَةُ سَبْعِ مِئَةِ عَامٍ 700 years between the earlobe and the shoulder of the angel. Look how far is it right now. In 1 second, I can do it twice. In 1 second, for the angel, the one that's holding Allah's throne, 700 years between the earlobe and the shoulder, something Wallahi, that should make us so humble. Something like, Ya Allah, how can I be arrogant? Wallahi, how could we? We're so tiny. But you know what's amazing? Even though myself and you are so tiny compared to Allah's creation, we are the most valuable thing in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is preparing this whole universe for me and you. Something that will call us the haya and the love to Allah al-Khaliq and al-Khalaq with these beautiful ahadith that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us. Another hadith to show you Allah al-Khalaq's magnificence. And these are the names of Allah for you to actually appreciate your Lord, for you to be in a state of awe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is my creator. You're so proud, you're so honored. Allah is al-Khaliq. Listen to this hadith. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنِّي أَرَى مَا لَا تَرَوْنَ وَأَسْمَعُ مَا لَا تَسْمَعُونَ I see things which you do not see, and I hear things that which you do not hear. أَطَّطِ السَّمَاءِ The sama, the sky, the heaven, has a squeaky noise. وَحُقَّ لَهَا أَن تَئِطْ And it has the right to have that squeaky noise. Why? وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ I swear by the one whom my soul is in his hands. مَا فِيهَا مَوْضِعُ أَرْبَعَ أَصَابِعُ Four fingers. There's no distance of four fingers, except there's an angel making sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاضِعٌ جَبْهَتَهُ سَاجِدًا لِلَّهِ اللَّهُ أَكْبَرُ So for the weight of these angels, Al-Khalaq created all these angels to an extent that the heavens are like the squeaky noise. You know when you walk on wood, and it's like the noise on the wood because the weight over it? The sama, that's what it went through, subhanAllah. This is authentic hadith. And after all that, the angels making sujood, all their life, all their existence. And يوم القيامة, just imagine, subhanAllah, or after all of that, they say, Subhanak, glory be to you, Allah. Ma abadanaka haqqa ibadatik. Ya Allah, we didn't worship you the way you deserve to be worshipped. Wallahi, it's something that humbles me very much. That because I'm giving you an episode of Allah's beautiful names, that now I'm giving all these halaqat, etc. I feel so special that I spend 2-3 hours a day talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is definitely an honor. I will not deny it. But thinking now I'm arrogant, a'udhu billah. And the angels have been worshipping Allah all the time. And they said at the end, Ya Allah, we didn't worship you enough. And wallahi, none of us worshipped Allah enough. And I shall never feel that I worshipped Allah enough. And you shall never feel that when you watch this or you spread this or you learn more about the deen, that you worshipped Allah the way He deserves to be worshipped. For wallahi, Allah deserves that something that none of us will ever be able to achieve. فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ. When Allah revealed the verse that we shall have taqwa towards Allah in the way that He deserves, the Sahaba could not. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ. Then have taqwa to Allah as much as you can. For we will not have taqwa to Allah the way Allah deserves. We have a lot of faults, and the best people of faults are those that repent right away. That sense of humbleness, haya, love towards Allah, and Ya Allah, we are here for a reason. I'm going to fill for that reason. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Al-Bari, when He created these angels, He made them transparent, send revelation with them. They protect the believers and they send mercy. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just like how this authentic hadith, when we talk about Allah, glorify Allah, the angels descend with their wings and cover upon us. وَغَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةِ. And the mercy descends upon all of us. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. We will continue inshaAllah with what was created after the angels. Perhaps they may be the jinn. We'll talk after the break inshaAllah. نعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. And from every horrible jinn. جزاكم الله خير. I'll see you shortly. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
If I were to ask you about the life of our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about the incidents that occurred before his prophethood and in Mecca and in Medina, about the names of his loved ones and his wives and his children, how much would we be able to know? How many incidents have we memorized? Brothers and sisters, isn't it more important that we study the seerah of the most important human being who ever walked the face of this earth? Join me, your host Yasir Qadhi, as we discuss the most important biography of the most illustrious human being that ever lived, the seerah of our beloved Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Join Yasir Qadhi in Seerah of the Prophet, peace be upon him, every Monday at 3:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 2 a.m. UK on Peace TV. Marriage or divorce?
What's Islamic ruling?
Nikah.
Solution or problem? Heaven or hell?
There is a misconception.
You choose. Beauty. Wealth. Family status, virtue. Decide what you want. Decide your choice. Be sad or be happy. It's your choice. Join Dr. Zakir Naik in Better Half or Bitter Half every Friday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV. Osama El Shami.
How can we get our children ready for the month of Ramadan?
Sharing the stories of what the Muslims have been through in the past, in particular the first generation.
Nazir Irfan Al Mujahid.
Make this Ramadan very special to them.
Your taqwa, your righteousness, your goodness.
I want you to tell me about your experiences from the very first Ramadan that you experienced as a new Muslim.
The first Ramadan I experienced was amazing.
Umar Debua.
When I embraced Islam, it was like I was prepared. You know, Allah prepared me for something that I had no idea. It was an amazing experience.
Beautiful. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome to our program, The Straight Path.
Build your character on the path of the Quran and Sunnah in The Straight Path. Next on Peace TV.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for being patient, tuning in after that short break. Continuing with Allah, Al-Khaliq, Al-Bari, Al-Musawwir, and Al-Khalaq. And we talked about the angels, and now moving forward to the creation of the jinn. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أعوذ بالله الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والجن خلقناه من قبل من نار السموم. And Allah created the jinn, al-jann, from smokeless flame of fire. From smokeless flame of fire. طيب, after that, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala create after this? All the birds, all the trees, the colors and the shapes, the oceans, the animals, everything they can think about in this dunya was created. And as I mentioned, there might be difference of opinion in terms of the orders, but definitely Allah created all of them. And whatever hadith I'm mentioning is authentic, bi'idhnillah. Now, with this being said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with all this creation, Allah says in the Quran, هَذَا خَلْقُ اللَّهِ. This is the creation of Allah. This is the creation of Allah. You are the creation of Allah. This universe is the creation of Allah. Then Allah says, فَأَرُونِي مَاذَا خَلَقَ الَّذِينَ مِن دُونِهِ. So show me, those that are you worshipping besides Allah, those whom people take as idols and lords, what did they create? Allah says, show me, what did you create? Let's see. Then Allah says, بَلِ الظَّالِمُونَ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. Those oppressors that put shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or say that some other god made another creation, this is dhulm and oppression, and they're in dalal, and they're astray. That is so clear astray, subhanAllah. We ask Allah to protect us. And Allah says in the Quran, subhanAllah, something to comprehend, وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدِرِهِ. And Allah subhanAllah says that the people did not give Allah the just due of how much Allah deserves. وَمَا قَدَرُ اللَّهَ حَقَّ قَدِرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبِضَتُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while the earth entirely will be within His grip on the day of resurrection. وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِهِ. And the heavens will be folded in His right hand in a way that befits His majesty. Then Allah says, after all that power, after all that creation, سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. Exalted is He and high above what they associate with Him. After all of this, how do we dare to associate anyone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Now everything is set, all of us are ready, and now the human beings are about to begin from Adam alayhi salam. And how did Adam, our father, come to existence? Look at these five steps I'd like to mention. Very humbling experience and knowledge for us. Number one, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ مَثَلَ عِيسَى عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ آدَمَ. The example of Isa is just like Adam. خَلَقَهُ مِن تُرَابِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him from? From what? What's turab mean? Soil, dust, whatever word that to mention. But the first thing is turab. Then after that turab, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do? هُوَ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِن طِينٍ. So these are different ayat from the Quran. Some people might mix and match, but this inshallah is the order. So afterwards, from soil to teen, to clay, sticky clay, طينٍ لازم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for that طين to come in place, that soil was mixed with water. So our main two components is dust or soil and water, the essence of life on this earth. You see how al-bari' created us in a way that fits our purpose in life? We were here as Khalifa to construct, reconstruct, and build this ummah, and Allah made us out of water and out of soil. Two pure things. Water we make wudu with. If there's no water, we make tayammum, right? With the soil, subhanAllah, or the dust. After that, number three, Allah says, وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ صَلْصَالٍ مِنْ حَمَئٍ مَسْنُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the insan, then it turned from clay or mud to a stinking black mud. Then afterwards, number four, what do you think happened? Number four, then it became a dried clay. خَلَقَ الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ صَلْصَالٍ كَالْفَخَّارِ. كَالْفَخَّارِ, a dry clay. SubhanAllah, what happened is that we became like hollow from the inside. Like khalas, like very stiff, just like that table. Very stiff and strong. But there's no ruh. He's not alive yet. Adam alayhi salam, Allah al-musawwir, has fashioned him. Allah fashioned his height, the width, the length, everything. But there's no ruh yet. Number five, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the last stage is the soul will be blown into Adam alayhi salam. Allah says, فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِن رُوحِي. And when Allah fashioned him, and Allah created Adam with his own hands, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our father, was made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be proud, subhanAllah, very humbling experience, and such an honor, wallahi, such an honor. Then Allah said, and when we blow the soul into him, فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ. Then all of you shall make sujood to this creation. Look at the honor once again. Allah created our father Adam with his own hands. He blew the soul from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي. And number three, Allah ordered the angels to prostrate to Adam alayhi salam, to prostrate the human being and some of his own progeny might not make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How is that possible? That the one who caused the whole world, the angels, all the millions of them, to make sujood to our father Adam, and now we're born and we don't make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we delay our prayers, we shall never do such thing. May Allah not make us do such thing. We ask Allah to always make us committed to our salawat. Then when the sajda by the angels came and Allah blew the soul into Adam alayhi salam, shaitan was very irritated, shaitan was very angry, he was upset. Allah said in the Quran, فَإِذَا سَوَّيْتُهُ وَنَفَخْتُ فِيهِ مِنْ رُوحِي فَقَعُوا لَهُ سَاجِدِينَ فَسَجَدَ الْمَلَائِكَةُ كُلُّهُمْ أَجْمَعُونَ. So all the angels made sujood, إِلَّا إِبْلِيس, except Iblis. Iblis, who was amongst the jinn, استكبر, was arrogant, وكان من الكافرين, and was amongst the disbelievers. Then Allah talked to Iblis. قَالَ يَا إِبْلِيسُ مَا مَنَعَكَ أَن تَسْجُدَ لِمَا خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيْهِ. O Iblis, what made you not make sujood to that which I created with my own hands? Astakbart? Are you arrogant? Are you being arrogant? Am kunt min al-aalin? Or do you think you're amongst those that are exalted? Then shaitan responds, قَالَ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِنْهِ. I am better than him. خَلَقْتَنِي مِنْ نَارِ. You made me out of fire. وَخَلَقْتَهُ مِنْ طِينَ. And you made him out of mud, out of clay. Subhanallah. We ask Allah not to have any arrogance in our hearts. Wallahi, how do we dare to say, I'm white, I am better than the black, and the black is better than the white, and the Arab is better than the non-Arab, and the non-Arab is better than the Arab. Na'udhu billah. We are judged according to that which is internal in our hearts, and only Allah knows that which is in the hearts. So we shall not judge one another who is better than the other. Na'udhu billah. We just judge externally, but we cannot judge people's sincerity. Is it clear? We cannot measure someone's taqwa. We can see the implication, but only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. And we shall not be like shaitan, being arrogant and saying he's a lower, degraded, and I'm better. Na'udhu billah. And shaitan is a fool. You know why? Because fire, compared to mud, fire is not really better than mud. Because think about it. Fire is furious. Fire can be more harmful. And mud was made to construct and build. Even if mud was not as good as fire, let's say fire is better than mud, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just because He created Adam with His own hands, it elevates His status over fire. Isn't that right? And even if fire was better than mud, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored the mud, which is Adam alayhi salam, through blowing the soul. So why is shaitan being arrogant about this, subhanAllah? Then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam, now all of us came from Adam alayhi salam. Al-Khalaq created all of us from different ways, four ways. He created from nothing, from no male or female. Who was it? Adam alayhi salam. Had no father or mother, or a female or a male component. Then he created from a male and not a female. What was it? Who was that one? Who was created from a male and not a female? It was the wife of Adam alayhi salam from his rib. Then Allah created someone from a female but not a male. Who was it? Isa alayhi salam. And just like how the first, second and last were all miracles, so is the last one, which is me and you. We came from both male and a female. Al-Khalaq created from every possible angle just for us subhanahu wa ta'ala to be amazed at the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is capable of doing everything and anything that which He wants. How about you read this hadith to see how myself and you came into existence, how Al-Khaliq created us. And again, the purpose of this talk, for you to have that sense of love, humbleness, haya, and bi-idhnillah fulfill the purpose of why you're here on this earth. Listen to this hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't forget, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, "Inna ahadakum yujma'u khalquhu fi batni ummihi 40 yawman nutfa." That verily the creation of each one of you is brought together in his mother's womb for 40 days in the form of a nutfa, a drop. Me and you came from a drop. We were a drop. Allahu Akbar. We were nothing. Subhanallah. It was narrated that Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu said, "How dare we become arrogant when our beginning is a drop? Had it come on our hand, we'll be disgusted and find it filthy and wash it away. That's our beginning. And our end is that we become a dead body that might smell bad and people cannot handle and how have to be buried. And in between, we are a bucket that holds nothing but waste. With all of this, how can we be arrogant?" Subhanallah. And to finish this hadith, really before we end the episode, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Rasulullah sallam, then after that drop, ثُمَّ يَكُونُ عَلَقَةً مِثْلَ ذَلِكَ, then that person will be like a clot of blood for a similar amount of period, 40 days. Then يَكُونُ مُضْغَةً مِثْلُ ذَلِكَ, then they become a morsel of flesh for 40 days. Then the last thing, after the three periods, 40, 40, 40, that's 120 days, after 120 days, the baby in the womb, Allah yursil ilayhi al-malak fayanfukhu fihi ar-ruh, and the ruh is blown into the soul of that baby and the heart starts pumping. And until today, not a single doctor was able to say how does the heart start beating. Nothing yet is confirmed. It's the ruh which Allah has allowed the angels to come and blow in them. What's the secret of that ruh? What is some of the beauties of Allah's khalq? We will inshallah continue for the last episodes of Allah Al-Khaliq, Al-Bari', Al-Musawwir, Al-Khalaq. The next episode inshallah, I look forward to see you once again. Barakallah feekum. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Praise be to my Lord Allah, praise Him every day. Say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, God is great. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, God is great. God is great. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, God is great.
Money in the hereafter will be measured by its proper use in the present.
Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu anfiqu mimma razaqnakum min qabli an ya'tiya yawmun la bay'un fihi wa la khullatu wa la shafa'a.
According to the glorious Quran, one of the best ways to use your money is to spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by spreading His message of Islam. Peace TV is a non-profit Islamic satellite television channel that is primarily dedicated for just that cause, the proper presentation of Islam. It's a great choice to invest in it and a golden opportunity to purify your wealth in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Support Peace TV. Send your zakat and donations to IRFI Al Rayan Bank, 47 Calthorpe Road, Birmingham, UK. B151TH. Pound account number 01132301. IBAN GB49ARAY 3000830113230 1. Sort code 300083. SWIFT BIC code ARAY GB22. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace TV, the solution for humanity.